shit exclusive.
Salute, folks. It's your boy, the insurance junkie, your fiduciary fella, the all-star advisor, Alonzo Hall, and I've returned today with another ADH Wealth Solution. Before I go in, ladies and gentlemen, make sure you hit that like, drop a comment, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you're made aware every time I release new content. And as always, share, share, share. Lastly, to contribute to channel growth, or to schedule an appointment with a licensed financial professional, the links are in the description of this video. Actually be with the people. Like we had to address Lawrence Smith Fields years ago with Senator Blumenthal. Showed you guys me with said Mayor Elliker on the cell phone. Now at the moment, what we're addressing is the homeless population that lives here. Now there are moments to this, right? As a resident of a person who actually lives here, maybe I am a person who possibly has gripes that you've seen some of the young people upset about. However, with that, there is a lack of job opportunities for all. Now, what we can do instead of complaining to the politicians is to actually ask them or to actually show up to the things like the city hall meetings and actually threaten them with votes. Because see, in this situation, what we're doing right now is talking. And talking doesn't get anything done. What gets done is, you've heard the term, the pen is mightier than the sword. Well, I happen to carry a Mont Blanc. So when you're writing with that type of a writing utensil, it happens to change things like legislation and law, right? So when you do things like, as opposed to Black Lives Matter attacking the city's money, which is then in turn paid by you, the taxpayer, you would do things like attack the policeman's pension. Those are the types of things you want to propose to your constituents. You actually want to be down here with them, right? In the trenches is great in front of their face. That's more of a PR opportunity for them, just like this video is a PR opportunity for me. I told you, I'm unorthodox. You're going to get the 100% from me. However, this is part of what they have to do to earn their salary, right? They have to actually be here for you. But to actually hear your words or to actually hear your complaints, we got to go write those papers. So if you want to say, as a homeless individual, you're a citizen, go be a citizen by affecting those votes. Your votes matter. What's good, brother?
Why do they have crippled people living in their streets?
Why do they have what?
Why do they have crippled people living in their streets?
Well, unfortunately, there's a multitude of reasons for that. So some of those reasons are choices that people make. You also have to look at things like the population, right? If you look at the population of just New Haven itself, there's 131,000 people at least, right? So with that 131,000, of those that are the police force, those that are to police our people, is a total of 300 people. You know why? Because you're not listening and allowing me to finish my statement, and you would like to hear what you would like to hear. See, I'm not a politician, so I can tell you the truth. I know, but I'm telling you the truth. So decisions that are made, right, and I'm not a politician. So, exactly.
Exactly.
So the way that this works is people do make decisions, and it is kind of like Reaganomics with a trickle down effect. So you have to put yourself in a position where instead of not listening, not a problem. So make sure that you put yourself in a position where if you're not listening, you're not going to get the result. Because now he's listening to someone talk as opposed to learning what the result of the situation is. This is why people get looked at as looking for handouts. You see, I'm a person who's an annual income of at least $150,000 myself, not including my wife, who's a PS14. So when we're looking at things like that, again, certain situations, we do have a heart and we like to help people compassionately, but we're also in a nationalist capitalist society, if you will. Okay. Not a nationalist socialist society. Okay. So in those things, our mayor is taking off, and again, he's still addressing the homeless people. Now they do have the opportunity for food and meals for people to eat. Okay. They have the opportunity for meals and things like that. So if we can go to those polls and make those differences, because this isn't a lot for the amount of people that are out here. We need job opportunities, right? So that means that a lot of things have to change in order to create those jobs, right? A person like me who could create jobs needs the support of the people to actually create jobs. But see, when I come talking, don't nobody want to hear shit I have to say. And then we wonder why we're in the conditions we're in, right? So, what ends up happening is we get inculcated with this and we feel like the politicians are BS. Now let's watch as he walks away, right? Because again, the absolute way to affect it is not to yell at the politician walking down the street, it's to actually do something. Threaten them with votes, or actually do things like I said, speak to the policeman pension, excuse me, right? You see? They're right here in New Haven. Right? So. How's it going, gentlemen? Oh man, I don't have my card with me. I'd be soliciting you guys. Your 457 is recovering finally, right? So. Now we've got some festivities. So it's again a different attitude. And this is kind of like bag chasing with Anton Daniels and the Millionaire Morning Show, the Millionaire Mindset, right? Now again, regular people do have issues with politicians, but they're probably coming down here, right? You see a lot of working class people down here, right? Who are doing things that, you see, it's a press opportunity, right? So they're doing some nice things. And they've got stuff laid out for us, right? And again, the mayor is here, right? So, you know, there goes my office, my New Haven office, right? But again, ladies and gentlemen, to get real change, right, you have to be open to hearing something. And the guy really didn't want to hear anything immediately. And I'm like, listen, there's things that happen. Oh, you sound like a politician. Okay, great. Well, then maybe there's a reason for that. Right? Maybe there's a reason you're in your situation. Right? There are ways to fight out of it. Right? So at any rate, with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, wipe ass. Work in progress every day and see success. Wipe ass. Work in progress every day and see success. Wipe ass. Work in progress every day and see success. And remember, folks, when people challenge you, they don't challenge you to challenge you, but they challenge you to challenge you. Accept the challenge. Salute. And before I go, we're going to take a little bit more look at this political event in New Haven, Connecticut, right by Yale University and etc. Let's look at this for a few more minutes. Downtown New Haven, luxury apartments, federal buildings, courthouses. There again is the mayor, Justin Ellicott, right? And we have got an event going. So, like I said, this is... Actually, I'll just come prospect later, but c'est la vie. Alright, salute.
So that's it for today, folks. Wipe ass, work in progress every day and see success. Wipe ass, work in progress every day and see success. Wipe ass, work in progress every day and see success. And remember, folks, when people challenge you, they don't challenge you to challenge you, but they challenge you to challenge you. Accept the challenge. Salute.